Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. It's me, Mustafa. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Blend Art Studio. First of all, thank you so much, guys, for supporting my previous video and helped me to reach till 100 plus subscribers. Some of the YouTubers had helped me a lot, and they are San Art Studio, Ringman 25, Color Art World, Maria Art, and Sketch Greyhood. Okay, so in today's work, we are going to work something extreme detailing with oil pastel. And also you are going to be introduced with one of the new technique called impasto, because whole oil pastel art depends on the impasto and types of oil pastel and impasto. Okay, to know more about it, we need to move towards the basic part. So let's start the basics. To know what is impasto and types of oil pastel, first of all you need to understand what are the mediums which are available in our surrounding. So the first, which reduces the thickness of the material, and the other, which layer above the material. Example, watercolors, tempera, printering, and the other, oil paint, and over here, oil paint, acrylic paint, oil pastels. Now let us see actual definition of impasto. Impasto means the process or technique of lying on paint. It means that we are overlapping the colors without mixing. It indicates that there forms a layer above the material, and these particular mediums are helpful for making impasto art rather than this one. As we are working with oil pastel, so it is important to know what are the categories of it. Actually, oil pastel have two types of category, as school grade and the student grade. School grade oil pastels are just similar to crayon and not much creamy. But the student grade oil pastels are much creamy and softer. The best oil pastel for impasto technique is student grade oil pastel, because they get overlapped without mixing. It is a chance when you are trying impasto technique with the school grade oil pastel, when for example you are applying a green color, and above that if you are applying yellow, it is a chance they get automatically blend and give you a blue color. But here the case is very rare. So whenever you want to overlap the color without mixing or blending, use soft grade oil pastel or student grade oil pastel. Okay, don't use school grade oil pastel. If you ask me, I suggest you to use both the oil pastel at a time at the part of detailing. How and when, at the last ending part of this video, I will say you. Before moving to the artwork, I want to remind you one thing, that I am going to use all the technique which I showed in my previous video of block A and block B. So let's recap them. I'm using saturation, lightening, darkening, diluting. Also I'm using impasto, one of the new technique, and strokes and dots also. I'm not gonna use sagraffito in this artwork, okay? If you don't know about this technique and my classification table, just you need to go and have a check my previous video. If not, just wait for a week. In my new upcoming video, I'm going to show the relation why I classified this oil pastel technique and table. Also, you will see one of the new artwork, okay? So I hope, guys, this much basics and this much talking is enough. So let's move on to the bigger artwork. In the name of Allah, Bismillah Rahman Rahim. So now, guys, we are working on the bigger artwork. Also, use steel ruler while working with the detailing. Don't use plastic and wooden ruler, because they have somewhat thickness at their corner. That is the reason we are not able to take a straight line properly. Okay, so always keep that thing in the mind and try to sketch out directly, because if you are making sketch directly, you can be able to identify the sketches, and also it will be a step that you will be perfect in sketching. Okay, for making this bigger artwork, you also need to be perfect in sketching, but that's the reason I am showing it in a very basic manner, that you should not to be confused. That's the reason I didn't first outline with the pencil. Okay, first, the main thing is important while working with grass is, with not grass in detailing, is going from lighter colors to darker colors. Okay, especially in the artwork where you have somewhat shadows, contrast and values, you can be able to see. I'm working on somewhat the contrast part. Contrast means nothing, only wherever the difference between the lighter color and the darker color, wherever the darker colors come, that is the contrast. Okay, actually that is one of the long process and long techniques in the oil pastel. That's the reason I am not making till now. My aim is to just to show you some simple and creative things by which you can create a masterpiece. Okay, one, till now also in my all videos I am saying to everyone, use bigger size of papers. Okay, because using bigger size of paper, you will get a clear understanding what I am doing, where I am applying lighter colors. Many of the artists are working on the small papers. That is good. But as you are a beginner, you don't know about it. If you are going to work on a larger area, there you can get a very wonderful image. And if your artwork gets successful, then you will be much confident to work on the bigger one. That is the reason. Don't take attention about the storage. Wherever you have the storage, you just keep there. I have a storage at the top of my almira. I am keeping there. You can also keep over there or under your table, or you can even it roll also, okay? And the main thing which I liked about the oil pastels is you don't need to have use of fixature spray. For example, for sketching, watercolors and any other paint, for acrylic paint also, you need to spray it once. But here there is no needed, okay? So let's come back to the topic. Say I am working on the downer part. See, first of all, you need to have a clear-cut image about the perspective also. Now I am working on the wall. See, I am working, taking random colors, and this is the auto blending of what I am talking about. I am using their school grade oil pastel. See, I am using lower area with the school grade oil pastel. I am not using the high. See, this is, now I overlap the colors on the grass. It means I use student grade oil pastels, okay? I hope you may getting somewhat confusion, but as how you are working with oil pastels, taking somewhat knowledge from the Google, Wikipedia, you can easily be able to understand. Now, this is the student-grade oil pastel on which I am taking layers. Actually, there is no need for me to first apply the colors on the wall and then flowers to just to show you this technique. Actually, if I didn't do this much work within 1 week, my artwork can be completed. But this work take nearly 1.5 weeks. because I worked somewhat fast on it. If not, it may can take 3 to 4 weeks also, nearly 1 month I can say it as, okay? So one thing you need to keep in the mind, whenever I overlap, it means I am using student grade, okay? Whenever I am giving as a base coat, that are school grade, okay? So as you can see, exceptions also comes in at the time of school student grade oil pastels, but you will get slowly. I will explain about that also. I will make one of the video about that, but till that time just you need to keep one thing: the colors which get overlapped, oil pastel which get overlapped are student grade, and which not get overlapped are school grade. Okay, see how wonderful it looks. Now I came on the detailing part. Till now I am just giving a base coat. At this time the power connection has somewhat connection in the power problem, okay? So that's the reason I am making this work and only in the flash of the phone. Even at that time I didn't have the light in my home, but no matter, I have managed because I need to upload the video, and many of the comments are coming when your next video is going to upload. So that's the reason. This is the extreme detailing part. I am using dot and stroke technique for making the tree. As you can see how real it looks, okay? So you need to work same like this. Nothing take pressure about it. Slowly you will also get the understanding, okay? See, I am working somewhat even more detailing. Now it is a time to use somewhat coconut oil. Yes. Wherever the place I didn't want to show it is highlighted, I am using coconut oil. And wherever I need to show it as detailed and highlighted, I am not using coconut oil, okay? So as you can see, I am working very hard. Somewhat part I am blending off the detailing, okay? So alhamdulillah, the work is at end.
Alhamdulillah guys, work done as you can see. So the 5 common tips you need to know while working with oil pastel. First, you need to have a horizontal surface. Second, you need to have a large size of paper as much you have. Third, apply a framework using masking tape. Fourth, whenever you are sketching, you need to have school grade oil pastels. The last tip is whenever you are creating an impasto effect or you are using impasto technique, you need to have student grade oil pastels. Important note of the day: don't use school grade oil pastel for impasto technique, and don't use student grade oil pastel for sketch out your work. Because school grade oil pastel are similar to crayon, whenever you are trying to give it an overlapping effect, they will cause auto blending. For example, I am applying a layer of green, and above that I am applying a layer of yellow. It will have a chance they get mixed and create a blue color. But whenever you are using student grade oil pastel, you applied a green color and then yellow color. The yellow color remains upside, as you can see over here. Whenever you feel you did somewhat mistake at the time of sketching, don't worry, just overwrap
then which student grade oil pastel. It means creamy oil pastel. With non-creamy oil pastel, you need to create sketch, and with creamy, you need to apply it as layers, as making the effect of this whole work. The main reason why I didn't upload any video from a week because I was busy in one of the art competition which is organized by the Nizam's Museum of Hyderabad. Over there, I got the first prize, and this is the proof. Let me bring it somewhat front. Yes guys, so as you can see, this is the national emblem of our state Hyderabad at the time of Nizam Kingdom. Actually, my plan is to upload this video on Friday, but as I got the news, I got the first prize. That's the reason I wait only for this shield to upload on the video to show you all my success and with this artwork, okay?
So guys, this is the time to end this video. Please guys, share this video to your contact to be more connected with me, and thanks again for the 100 plus subscribers. Till then, Allah Hafiz, bye bye, take care.